Since publishing my first book on Amazon back in 2019, I have witnessed countless updates to how books are uploaded to Amazon KDP. In this video, I will show you how to correctly fill in the book title and subtitle fields while following Amazon KDP's guidelines to avoid book blocks or account termination. If this video gets 1000 likes, I will quickly create separate videos for each field to guide you through the process. So if you find this helpful, don't forget to like and comment to support the channel. First thing first, ensure you have your book cover and a properly formatted manuscript before uploading your book to Amazon KDP. If you have all that ready, we can proceed with the upload. The first step is to visit kdp.amazon.com. If you already have an account, click sign in. If not, click join KDP to create one. Once you are signed in, your dashboard will look like this. To upload a book to KDP, click the create button and select the type of book you want to create, such as an ebook, paperback, or hardcover. I will choose paperback since 97% of my royalties come from paperback sales. Here's the plan. For each field, first we will go over the guidelines and then I will share my personal experience and show you how to optimize these fields based on the latest AI updates from Amazon. The first step is selecting the language. If your book is in English, simply leave it set to English. Next, move on to the book title. The title is the very first thing readers see or hear about your book, so it's crucial to get it right. First and foremost, make sure you enter the title exactly as it appears on your book's cover. This is what will show up on Amazon's page for your book. Maintain consistency in your book title across all formats, whether it's paperback, hardcover, or ebook. This ensures they are linked together on a single Amazon page. Additionally, avoid including prohibited elements in the title fields, as outlined in the KDP Help Center. For instance, repeating generic keywords like notebook, journal, gifts, or books is a common mistake among KDP beginners that often leads to rejection at the publishing stage. A frequent error is using notebook in the title while adding journal or book in the subtitle. While some older books may still sell well with such titles, they were likely published before stricter enforcement of these rules. Since the guidelines are clearly stated in the KDP Help Center, it's best to follow them carefully. Moreover, avoid using trademark terms in your title or subtitle. You can check the status of trademarks through the relevant marketplaces, patent and trademark office. For example, Bullet Journal is listed as live and registered under Class 16 on the United States Patent and Trademark Office website, meaning it cannot be used. Always verify each term in your book title and subtitle to ensure compliance. Adhering to these practices is essential for protecting your account. A common question is, what should the ideal length of a title and subtitle be? Longer titles are harder to read and risk losing a customer's attention. According to the KDP Help Center, customers are more likely to skim past long titles over 60 characters. Similarly, the Amazon Help Center recommends keeping product titles concise. The Amazon product title character limit is 200, but we recommend no more than 60. Include only the most important keywords to capture the attention of your intended customer. In one of my videos, I conducted an experiment to find the optimal character length for titles and subtitles. I analyzed 141 books across 3 different niches. I will include the video link in the description so you can watch it and learn how to perform a similar test for your niche. Based on my experiment, here is an optimized formula for Amazon KDP titles and subtitles. Title: aim for around 5 words with a total character count between 50 to 60. Subtitle: keep it around 100 characters for low content books. To improve visibility on both mobile and desktop, include the most relevant keywords within the first 80 characters. Although Amazon allows up to 200 characters, it's better to use fewer because not all characters will be visible on search engine results pages. Titles and subtitles often get cut off at specific points depending on the device being used. For example, take the popular Coco Wyos Stress Relief Coloring Book. While the product page displays the full 200 character title and subtitle, only 121 characters are visible on the desktop search results page. On mobile, this visibility drops to just 85 characters. To ensure your title and subtitle are effective across all platforms, always consider these cutoff points. I continue to write my titles based on the results of my experiment and the guidelines outlined in the KDP Help Center, as I have explained. However, on September 19, 2024, Amazon announced the use of generative AI to enhance product recommendations and descriptions. This means Amazon may adjust product titles and subtitles to emphasize features they consider most relevant to customers based on product attributes and customer data, such as preferences, search queries, browsing history, and purchase patterns. This feature is currently being tested across various product categories. While I don't believe Amazon will alter book titles, they may modify subtitles, especially for low content books. For example, if you include the book size at the end of the subtitle, Amazon might move it to the beginning to make it more noticeable for customers specifically searching for that size. This update suggests that the order of words in the title might carry less weight in the new algorithm for ranking. However, these updates are still very new, so it's uncertain. For now, I continue to follow the practices I have shared, relying on the insights from my experiments. I also want to inform you that Amazon updated its product title requirements for FBA and FBM products on January 21st, 2025 to standardize listings and improve the shopping experience. Here's what's changed. For most product categories, titles may not exceed 200 characters, including spaces. This is also mentioned in the KDP Help Center, so it's something book publishers should keep in mind as well. These special characters are not allowed unless they are part of the brand name. Not all of these characters are listed in the KDP Help Center, but after this update, I'm personally avoiding them, just to be safe, even if this policy may not officially apply to books yet. Titles may not contain the same word more than twice. Prepositions, articles, and conjunctions are exceptions. Since we just talked about generic keywords, it's a good idea to consider this when crafting your book titles and subtitles as well. These updates are now in effect, and for KDP authors, while these rules don't officially apply to books yet, following them can help keep your titles clean and professional. I hope you liked the video. As I said, if this video gets 1000 likes, I will quickly create separate videos for each field to guide you through the process. So if you found this helpful, don't forget to like and comment to support the channel. See you soon.